Hello everyone, this is Bhavik Chokshi. Today's video is mainly for the students in May 19 as well as November 19 who are planning to opt for paper 6E GFRS as their elective paper in the CA final new course. As you would be aware, this paper has a significant amount of overlap with paper 1, that is financial reporting. All the study modules from module 2 up to module 6 of the new syllabus are covered in this paper. Apart from that, the institute has issued a few other items that will be covered, which include the differences between IFRS and Ind AS, which is also called as a carve-out, the differences between IFRS and US GAAP, largely which is important from a theory base, and a few IFRICs and SICs, which are corresponding to appendix in Ind AS. Okay, so we are starting a batch on GFRS that would be from 26th of December to 18th of January. This is a live batch which would be happening at Andheri from 5:30 to 9 in the evening. We would also have this batch in the recorded mode, the online mode, where you would have pen drives as well as Google drives. So we would just want to discuss the broad layout, the broad plan on what is going to be covered under this batch. Okay, so when we are looking at this, we would be touching upon six main areas of the batch. It would take around 60 odd hours to complete this batch. As a first instant, we would cover a quick revision of all Ind ASs. So over here, we kind of assume that you have gone through the Ind ASs in paper 1. Having said that, we do a very quick recap before we jump on the main syllabus. Okay, so we do a quick recap of all the Ind ASs. That would be very helpful for you to revise even your paper 1 as well as to have a good head start in paper 6. Okay, then we move on to IFRS versus Ind AS. So these are called as carve-outs, essentially, where there's a difference between IFRS and Ind AS. Honestly, there are very limited differences, around 17 to 18 items where IFRS and Ind AS differ. We'll be doing cases along and as well as small illustrations to illustrate those differences between IFRS and Ind AS. This is something which I would reckon as important. Then we look at IFRICs and SICs. Now, this is nothing but guidance on specific transactions. Again, in Ind AS, this is covered as a part of appendix. So you might have studied, gone through appendix on service concession, which is a part of construction contract, the old standard. You also have appendix on, let us say, distribution of non-cash assets to owners. This is an appendix to Ind AS 10, which is on events occurring after the balance sheet date. In such a way, there are various appendixes which are dedicated to specific transactions and which are not covered in as much detail in the financial reporting paper. Institute does not really ask a lot of sums on the appendixes. In fact, you hardly have even many sums, even the study material are not there. So there's a lot of theory on the appendix, not as much covered under paper 1. And if you look at the May 18 paper specifically and also the November 18 paper, a lot of cases, questions, a lot of them have come through the appendixes the IFRICs and SICs. So we would try to do this in a lot of detail. I'm absolutely sure that you would get questions on this in your main paper. Then you have certain advanced concepts on certain important items which have had a repeated higher weightage in May 18 as well as November 18, something like income tax, Ind AS 12, something like financial instruments have a slightly higher weightage. So we would be discussing the advanced concepts which may not be covered in as much detail in paper 1 in financial reporting on certain items. And also we would be discussing the disclosures. So when we study paper 1, we really focus on the sums. We don't really focus a lot on the disclosures. While doing paper 6E, even the disclosures are important. So we would be doing some advanced concepts as well as disclosures. Then there is the part of US GAAP versus IFRS. Now in May 18, there was really no weightage on this, but however in November 18 you do have some weightage on US GAAP and IFRS both. So we will be discussing the differences between US GAAP and IFRS, though I would put a slightly lower weight or importance to this part as compared to the differences between IFRS and Ind AS, which is a lot more important. And to end this, we would be doing case studies. We would majorly be doing case studies which are covered by the ICI, specifically those covered in the May 18 and the November 18 exams. Apart from that, the institute has issued 6 other case studies, and there are a few other case studies which are there as a part of your mock test papers. We would be largely covering most of the case studies from there, and also selected case studies from the ACCA, the international exam. This would be helping you to solve in an open book and a case study format. Again, this is an important for practice, because as you would have been aware, in the May 18 as well as November 18 paper, students really struggle to complete, not just the GFRS paper, but most of elective papers by the sheer length of the paper. So it is very important to do practice on case studies and how to solve it in an open book setting. So while solving case studies, we would mark the relevant and important items in your study material. We would remember be doing this along with your study material. We would be giving a very detailed index on the contents, on their placement in the study material. So once you are used to that, you know where to refer for something even in the main exam. Okay, so that is about our plan. We would plan to first do a quick recap on all the Ind AS's, a very good revision, followed by a comparison between IFRS and Ind AS along with a few sums and cases, followed by doing the FRICS and SICS in a lot of detail because that has carried a lot of weightage, going to the advanced concepts of certain items like share-based payment, financial instruments, income taxes, etc., and a few disclosures which are not dealt in as much detail while you are studying paper 1. We go to the largely theory part of US GAAP versus IFRS, including a few sums and illustrations, but largely a theory part, and then devolving into the main solutions, that is solving of your case studies, how to do it in an open book setting, helping you with the solving of case study approach. Fair. Okay, so now in terms of the batch, this will be a live batch to start with. It will be starting on 26th of December, ending 18 January on weekdays. It is an evening batch, 5:30 to 9. In case you have some other commitments, on a few days, we have video backups for the lectures missed in case of the live batch. So you can get the video backups for the lectures missed so that you can cover up whatever you have missed. Faculty would be myself, Bhavik, and the fees would be 5,500. This is all inclusive. The lectures would also be available in pen drive format, which is 4,500 rupees for the pen drive, and downloadable through Google Drive, which will be 4,000 rupees. So essentially, this would be covering GFRS. It is a very interesting paper, but again, something that you should be doing if you love paper 1 financial reporting, largely a case-based as well as sum-based paper. So that is it. In case you have any queries, doubts, or in case you're interested in the batch, please do contact these contact numbers given to you. Looking forward. Thank you very much. And in case you like the video, please do like, share, subscribe. Thank you very much.